In this video, I want to show you a really cool feature of Xcode 15 that kind of flew a bit under the radar. Right now, I'm showing you a typical Swift UI view inside Xcode 15, and I want to draw your attention to the preview we have right here. If you've been writing Swift UI code before Xcode 15 was released, you've probably noticed that the syntax to create a preview has changed quite a bit. It used to be that you had to declare a struct that would conform to the protocol preview provider, but since Xcode 15, this syntax has changed quite a bit because now we use the macro pound preview, we give it a closure, that closure returns a view, here it returns the content view, and the macro will take care of displaying inside the preview whatever view is returned by the closure. But the really cool thing with this new syntax is that it's no longer only limited to displaying a Swift UI view in the preview. Inside the preview, if you return a UIKit view, your preview will also be able to display it. And I want to show you an example of how to do it. So I've moved to a new Swift file and I'm going to start by importing the framework Swift UI because previews are part of Swift UI. Then I'm going to declare a preview. So I use the pound preview macro. And inside the closure I give to the macro, I'm going to start by creating a UI label, so which is part of UIKit. Actually, I'm going to also import UIKit so that it's very clear that I'm using both UIKit and Swift UI in this file. Then I'm going to configure this label. So I will set its text and I will say, hello UIKit world. If I manage to write it correctly, it will be better. And last thing, I will have the closure return the label. And as you can see, a preview has appeared and this preview is displaying the view I've returned inside my closure. And it works perfectly fine, even though this view is a UI label, which is part of UIKit and not of Swift UI. And so as we've just seen, even if your project only uses UIKit, as long as you're using Xcode 15, you can leverage a preview in order to easily see the content of a view or a view controller without needing to launch your app inside a simulator or a real iOS device. That's all for this video. I hope you've enjoyed discovering this pretty cool feature of Xcode. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss my next video. Thank you for watching and see you next time.